Bonjour. So today we start on chapter 10 of Transmath Class de Troisième book. This is this chapter, chapter 10, Étudier l'effet d'un agrandissement réduction. And this is on page number 146. Okay, so we will start this today. Agrandissement et réduction des figures géométriques. This is the title that should have been there of this particular chapter. In English, agrandissement is enlargement, réduction is reduction. So that is when you enlarge and reduce a geometric figure. What is a geometric figure? A figure, geometric figure is any drawing of any shape. It can, that is on paper, it is a two-dimensional drawing, but it can also be a three-dimensional figure, something like a pyramid or a cylinder or a sphere. So all that we learn in this chapter will be to do with two-dimensional drawings to begin with, but we'll also discuss three-dimensional figures like cylinders and pyramids. Okay, so these two geometric operations, this is our first chapter on geometry. You will require in this, now you will require a straight edge, a ruler, you will require a rapporteur, you will require a compass, and you will require a good pencil. But all these you know, so I won't spend time on that. Okay, so these two geometric operations are what are known as geometric transformations. This is a general term, geometric transformations, to apply to when you turn one geometric figure into another. There are four basic simple ones. The first is translation. And don't get confused with this word translation. In English, and indeed in French also, translation doesn't only mean going from one language to another, like French to English or English to French. It also means moving or moving something. So if I translate something from here to there, that means I moved it from here to there. It's a technical term mainly used in science and mathematics. So now geometric transformations are also things that you can do to figures in computer drawing programs. The most famous of them now is Adobe Illustrator. So you can do all of this, you can do a translation, you can drag a figure on the computer, in a drawing on the computer. For example, if I did this thing on the computer and I didn't want to put that Shapit 10 there, this funny shaped blue-gray thing, I could have moved this from there to here. That is known as a translation. I moved from somewhere to somewhere. In common language, it is called drag, or in French, glisser. And the information you require to move, to translate something, is which direction to send it, to move it to this direction, that, and how far to move it once you specify the direction. This information is usually contained in a mathematical item, mathematical construct called a vector. A vector contains a direction and a distance or a magnitude together. We will not go into detail. If what I have said you haven't understood, just ignore it about vectors. You will learn about it later. The second geometric transformation is resizing, where you take a figure and you make it bigger or smaller, and that is actually the main topic of this chapter, enlarging and reducing a figure. So this is what we will spend doing in this chapter. The third is rotation. If you take a figure and you rotate it, that is called rotation. Again, you have to know how much you want to rotate in degrees. You want to rotate 30 degrees clockwise or 30 degrees anti-clockwise, and around which point you want to rotate. So that also you have. So suppose this pen represented a geometrical drawing. I could rotate it like this around this point. This is my center of rotation. I could also rotate it around this point, in which case it would rotate like that, around that center of rotation. So when you do rotation, you have to specify the angle and the center of rotation. the last one common geometric transformation is mirroring. That is, you take a symmetry. So if you have a drawing of something, if this is the pen, represents a drawing, and if I want to mirror it against this line, this vertical axis, then it becomes like this. Okay. You can take a mirroring, you can symmetry across an axis or a point. Again, if you have not understood, don't bother, don't worry rather. This is the only topic we are going to cover in this chapter. I just wanted to give you an overview of the other geometric, common geometric transformations. These geometric transformations can be combined. First you move this thing to there and then you rotate it, or first you enlarge it, then you move it, then you rotate it, then you take its symmetry. All of these can be done in sequence and can be combined. Okay. So now we start with the resizing, which is enlargement and reduction. And here we will start with, let's take, I have a figure like this. This is part of a rectangle, and then there's a curve and there's a pointy bit there. And I've drawn it two times bigger. So I have two squares here in my notebook. So I made that four squares. I have one square there. I made it two squares. Similarly, this thing was half a square high. So now it's become one square high. So here I've taken this A, B. I've named just two points. They correspond to A' and B'. Yeah. What is it in English? A dash, A prime, A dash, B dash. And so this into 2 is called the factor of resizing, K. It's commonly called K. It is a factor of resizing. It means how much times you want to make this bigger. If K is bigger than 1, then you are enlarging. If K is smaller than 1, then you are reducing. So whatever, any measurement you take on this original figure, it will be twice as long in the final figure, because we are enlarging by a factor of 2. So A' A dash B dash is equal to K into AB. Okay, right. If K is bigger than 1, then it's called enlargement, agrandissement. If K is smaller than 1, then it's called reduction. It's reduced. We will just see an example of that. And if K is equal to 1, then it's called reproduction, because you are just copying the figure somewhere else with the same size. It's actually, then it becomes a translation, because you're just moving the figure rather than enlarging or reducing it. So here we can take another example I've done, where I take a semicircle, and which is a pointy end. It, you can think of it as a cup of ice cream. And here I make it half the size. So this was 4 squares on my notebook. I made it 2 squares. This was 2 squares down. It becomes 1 square down. That was 1 square up. It becomes half a square up. So this is what I get. I multiply it by 0.5. K is less than 1. Then I am getting a reduction. So basically the whole chapter is about this. Enlarging and reducing. We can see this here. Yeah. In this page 148, you have this top part is what we are going to talk about today. Agrandir ou réduire une figure, c'est construire une figure the même forme, that means the same shape, en multipliant les longueurs de la figure initiale par un nombre k strictement positif. You cannot have k smaller than 0. In a way you can, but that expands the definition of K. We will come to that much later in a chapter called Theorem de Thales. Okay. See, vocabulaire on the K et le rapport d'agrandissement ou de réduction, that is the ratio. Si K est plus grand que 1, il s'agit d'un agrandissement. Si K est entre 0 et 1, il s'agit d'une réduction. Si K est égal à 1, il s'agit d'une reproduction. So this last one is basically what we call translation. We're moving from one place to another, but the top one is enlargement, the second one is reduction. Okay? So we come back to my notebook, and so I have my original figure ABCD 1 square. In my notebook it is 1 square wide, 1 square tall, and I enlarge it by a factor of 2, ratio of 2, so I get A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. This is 1, each side is 1 square, here each side is 2 squares. So I have multiplied it, I have enlarged it by 2. A dash, B dash is twice AB, B dash, C dash is twice BC, and so on. I can also draw it here again, the same thing, I have enlarged it twice. So my question is, which of these is correct? Is this correct or this correct? Now obviously both are correct. This is twice this size and this is twice this size. So both are correct. But in mathematics you would rather have only one defined answer. So in this in this situation you also have to specify not only k, that is the ratio of enlargement or reduction, but you also have to specify the final position of where you want the drawing, where you want the figure. And the way they do it is very neatly, it's called, so this is what I say here, so additional information is required to determine the position of the resized figure. Which, is this correct or is this correct? So some additional information is required. This is provided by the something called the center of homotheta. It's a fancy word, homotheta, but it basically in French sounds through the homotheta. It is just a reference point from which the resizing is done. So I'll explain that to you. It's not complicated, but basically what you do is, if this is your original figure A, B, C, D. You know, I'm drawing these freehand, but you will, when you draw, you will draw with a scale and ruler and compass and all, and you will do proper geometric drawings because I will grade your assignment also on the neatness and correctness of the drawings. Okay, so here we have this square, and I say K is twice. So this, you can see AB is twice the size of AB here. This square ABCD, I got A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. This is twice the size. But I gave a center of homotheta. So when you take a center of homotheta, what you do is you draw from that center of homotheta, usually it's called O, a line to every point in your original figure. So you draw a line OA and just continue it. It's a dummy dhruvat, a ray, starts at O and continues. So I have OA. And it continues. I have one line OB, I have one line OC, I have one line OD. Then what you do is you measure OA, you multiply it by K, in this case 2, and you mark out O A dash, O A prime. Similarly, you measure O B and you mark out O B prime, where O B prime is twice OB. You do the same with C and you do the same with D. You do, if the figure has more corners or more nodes, more points, you do it for as many points as is necessary. Then you just join these four points you've marked, and you will get a figure that is twice the size, and because you have specified the center of homotheta there, the position is fixed here. So first, this is what I say, OA, OA prime, OA prime, et egala K fois OA, ici D fois OA, où A prime appartient à demi droite OA. You have to take on this side, you don't take it on the other side there. You take it on this side, and similarly you mark out OB prime, OC prime, OD prime. These four points you mark out, when you join them, you'll get a figure that is twice as big as the original figure. When you measure AB and you measure A prime, A dash, B dash, you will get that this is twice the size of that. Now, if I move the point O here, suppose O was here, then this figure would move up, because all the lines would go up that way, this figure would move up somewhere here. So basically, O is determining the position of the final figure. The center of homotheta is determining the position of the final figure. This is not there in this chapter, by the way. This will come in a later chapter, a chapter on theorem of Thales of proportionality, which also will say something very interesting, is that AB is parallel to A dash B dash, that it will prove. But we don't need to think about that right now. Okay, and here we can see that K, that is a ratio, is equal to A dash B dash over AB, B dash C dash over BC. So all the four sides is also equal to OA dash over OA, OB dash over OB, OC dash over OC is equal to OD dash over OD is equal to 2. All of the, each one of these ratios is equal to 2. Okay, so now I would have liked to draw a different O and then a different A, A the prime, B the prime, C the prime, D the prime, another square somewhere else, but then my drawing would become too complicated. So I have done that with I've done that for another drawing, but separately, two separately. So here, I take the same square, A, B, C, D. When I say same, it's because it's the same size. I put O very close there, and I say K is equal to 2. So O1 A prime, O1 B, B dash. I'm sorry, I'm mixing up my French and English. But you'll excuse me, you understand what I'm trying to say. And when you join this, you will see that you get a square where it is twice as big, but it is sort of overlapping this. Why? Because O is so close. If I put O here, then the square would have been probably be somewhere here. So, you understand, this figure and this figure, this square and that other square are identical. This red square and this red square are identical, but their positions, relative positions, are different because the position of O is different. Now I take another example, again the same example. I take A, B, C, D, and this time I put O in the center there. So what do I get? OA, I have to take there, A prime is on OA, B prime is on OB, C prime is on OC, and D prime is on OD. And again, I get a square like this. So in this case, because the O is inside this, the square is around the initial square. Now I am drawing squares, but this will work for any geometric figure, even figure with curves and circles and triangles, everything. Any polygon, any polygon or any geometric figure, it will even work for three-dimensional figures like pyramids or cylinders or spheres, but we will look at that later. Okay, so let's take another example. Now these are examples of enlargement, because K is greater than 1. In fact, it's a simple enlargement of double. Now we can take an example of reduction. So original triangle I have ABC. I put my O there and I say K etegala 0.5. So this case OB goes there, OB prime sur OB. So instead of taking twice this as I would have done in the previous case, I'm taking half of it. OB prime etegala 0.5 OB. And here I have the same condition. B prime appartient damidruat OB. It's on this side. It's not on the other side of this line. Other side of O. So if I do that, I'll get a triangle A prime, B prime, C prime, and this triangle again is half of that, because K etegala 0.5. When you try to when you measure, you'll see AB is certain size, A prime, B prime is exactly half that size. Similarly, B C and B prime, C prime, AC and A prime, C prime And indeed, you will also notice, if you draw it properly, that this line is parallel to this line, that line is parallel to that line, and that line is parallel to that line. The corresponding sides of the triangles are parallel, but that is, again, as I said, we'll come to that in a later chapter. Here we are only concerned about enlarging and reducing. So, K et égal à 0,5 is equal to the ratio of the three sides. This is half of that, and also OB prime is half of OB, OC prime is half of OC, and OA prime is half of OA. Okay, so I hope you've understood that if you are given this, if you are given a figure, initial figure, in my case I've drawn them in blue, and if I'm given a centre d'homothétie, then there's only one figure that can result. One agrandissement or reduction figure that can result. And that leads me to today's in-video problems. So here, I've drawn a funny figure. This is AB, 2 centimeters. This is BC, 1 centimeter, same as AE also, that is also 1 centimeter. And this point D is 0.5 centimeters. And here also, this is also 0.5 centimeters. So, this is my initial figure. The first thing is you put O1 somewhere there and you draw a figure that is 1.5 times this. So, you'll have to join O to C to B to D to E and A and extend that and follow what I've taught there. Then you draw the same figure by putting O here. You don't try to do it on the same drawing. You copy that. So basically this A has two parts. One with this and one with this. So you have to draw this twice. Make it separate figure just like I have done here. I've got one O1 there. I've got one O there. Here also. Draw it separately. And take a reduction here, ka et égal à 0,7. Now, this might be a little easier to draw because you are enlarging it. This might be a little trickier to draw because in all your dimensions will become half. It will be a very small drawing. So, I will judge you on the quality of your drawing. Don't draw freehand. Draw with the ruler. Measure properly. Divide with your calculator if you need to. And then mark it correctly. Okay? Okay, now we come to the last problem. This is B. Here it's very simple. Here I have a half a circle with the diameter. Radius is equal to 15 millimeters. And here I say, draw it with a ratio of 2.5. That means 2.5 times bigger than that. And the O1 I have placed there. So place it approximately where I have placed it. And you draw the enlarged semicircle at with a factor of 2.5. Okay, I stop here.